Привет, and welcome to lesson 22 of my Russian language course. I'm your host, Dmitry Slomov. In the previous lessons of this course, we have talked pretty much about meeting our friends, scheduling activities together, and going for visits. Usually, when we get acquainted with new people, we are likely to be interested about their life, their families, and so on. Moreover, for Russians, you are a foreigner, so you are even more interesting. When you get acquainted with Russians, be ready that you will be asked a lot of questions about yourself. So in the next lessons, we shall learn to speak about ourselves, our life in general, and about our families, all in Russian. So, imagine that Anna has arrived to Russia together with her boyfriend Jack. Now Anna and Jack are being introduced to a Russian family. First of all, Anna may be asked about her name, remember? What's your name? Or in Russian way, how do they call you? Как тебя зовут? Как тебя зовут? But Anna could also be asked in a polite way. So instead of тебя, her Russian, let's say, colleagues would say вас. Как вас зовут? This is a polite form, and it is used in formal situations. Now, Anna replies, my name is Anna. Or me, they call Anna. Меня зовут Анна. Anna could also introduce Jack. She could say, this is my friend Jack. This is это. Это. My, when we talk about male persons, мой. Similar to English my. Мой. Friend, when we talk about a male person, друг. Друг. Друг does not necessarily mean boyfriend. This may be any friend who is a guy. When two guys are friends, they refer to one another друг. When a lady has a friend who is a guy, she may have a relationship or may have no relationship with him. As he is a guy, he will be anyway called друг. So, Anna says, это мой друг Джек. Это мой друг Джек. But she can also say like, this is my friend. His name is Джек. His name is, or actually him, they call him in Russian, его. Его. So Anna says, это мой друг. Его зовут Джек. Его зовут Джек. Very good. Now, Джек can also introduce Anna. He may say, this is my friend. Her name is Anna. My, when we talk about a lady, the Russian word мой needs to get the lady sound а at the end. So it becomes моя. Моя. Friend, when spoken about a lady, sounds подруга. Подруга. The word друг still can be heard inside. Подруга. Similarly to the meaning of the word друг, the word подруга refers to any friend who is a lady, whether or not you have a relationship with her. Jack says, это моя подруга. Это моя подруга. Her they call Anna. Her in Russian, ее. Ее. Ее зовут Анна. Jack says, это моя подруга. Ее зовут Анна. Very good. And let's say he is in the family of his Russian friend Ivan, or informally, Vanya. Vanya presents his family to Anna and Jack. His mom, in Russian, мама. Это моя мама. Ее зовут Людмила. And his dad, in Russian, папа. А это мой папа. Его зовут Василий. His brother, in Russian, брат. Брат. Это мой брат. Его зовут Борис. And his sister, in Russian, сестра. Сестра. Это моя сестра. Ее зовут Юля. And let's say Vanya is married to a lady whose name is Natasha. Wife, in Russian, жена. Жена. Like Jack has a wife, Jane. Жена. Vanya says, это моя жена. Ее зовут Наташа. And for example, if Natasha would present Vanya, she would need to say, this is my husband. Husband in Russian, муж. Муж. So Natasha would say, это мой муж. Его зовут Ваня. At this step, please do the drill number one, as described in your transcript. Very well done. Now, Vanya has introduced his family to Anna and Jack. But Anna's family is far away. She cannot introduce her family members, but she can talk about them. So let's say Anna's friend Jack remained home and did not go to Russia with her. Anna would talk about him. I have a friend. My friend's name is Jack. Now, in English we say, I have a friend. Or, for example, Ivan has a wife. Or, Ivan has a summer cottage. Or, Natasha has a car. Car, in Russian, машина. Машина, like machine. Машина. But it is a car. In Russian, we say it slightly different. We do not say that some person has something. We say that somewhere or by someone there is that thing. Like, at home there is mineral water. Дома есть минералка. Or, by Ivan there is a car. Or, by Tanya there is a summer cottage. Дача. By Ivan, exactly like we were saying when we wanted to meet at Ivan's place. У Ивана. У Ивана. And there is, in Russian, есть. Есть. So, if you want to say that Ivan has a car, by Ivan there is a car. У Ивана есть машина. У Ивана есть машина. The word машина does not change. The car is. Nothing is being done to it or given to it, or so it remains машина. Or we may say that Ivan has дача. У Ивана есть дача. Or we may say that Сергей has a дача. У Сергея есть дача. Or Anna has a car. У Анны есть машина. Even if we are talking about a number of persons or things, the word есть remains the same. It is always есть. Коля has mom and dad. Mom in Russian mama and dad papa. So we say, у Коли есть мама и папа. And of course we may say about our pets. In Russia, the most popular pets are cats and dogs. A cat, namely a tomcat, a male cat, in Russian, кот. Кот. Like a cat. Кот. Сергей has a cat, male. У Сергея есть кот. And if there is no cat, we say, нет кота. Нет кота. Сергей has no cat. У Сергея нет кота. A pussycat, a female cat, in Russian, кошка. Кошка. Anna has a cat, female. У Анны есть кошка. And if there is no pussycat, нет кошки. Нет кошки. Anna has no pussycat. У Анны нет кошки. And finally, a dog. Собака. Собака. Jack has a dog. У Джека есть собака. Jack has no dog. У Джека нет собаки. У Джека нет собаки. See, in Russian we say собака about both a male and a female dog. And in similar way, we may say that in some place there is something. At home there is milk. Milk – молоко. Молоко. Дома есть молоко. And you may say about a number of things. At home there is milk and tea. Дома есть молоко и чай. You may say there are some things. It is all the same. Есть. At dacha, there are pieces of meat roasted on live coals. Шашлыки. Шашлыки. So it becomes на даче есть шашлыки. Some more expressions. I have a brother. У меня есть брат. You, one, have a sister. У тебя есть сестра. We have a friend. У нас есть друг. You many have a friend who is a lady. У вас есть подруга. Do you, one, have a girlfriend? У тебя есть подруга? Do you, one, polite, have a husband? У вас есть муж. Very good. Now please do the drill number 2 as described in your transcript. Great. Very well done. Now, Anna wants to say that she has a friend. She also wants to say, my friend's name is Jack, or my friend they call Jack. In this case, something is being done to my friend. Namely, people call him. So from мой друг, it becomes моего друга. Моего друга. Мой turns to моего. And the word друг gets an ending а. Моего друга зовут Джек. Or моего друга зовут Ваня. Similarly, the words брат and муж also get an а sound if you say моего мужа зовут Иван. Моего мужа зовут Василий. Моего брата зовут Николай. Моего брата зовут Петя. Be careful about the word кот. It does not only get the а ending, it also changes its stress. Моего кота зовут Барсик. Моего кота зовут Барсик. With words that end with а sound, things go a little bit easier. А just turns to у. So with ladies, when we want to say my friend lady, they call so-and-so, or let's say my sister, they call so-and-so, we say мою подругу зовут Анна. Мою подругу зовут Анна. Or мою маму зовут Наташа. Мою маму зовут Наташа. Or мою жену зовут Таня. Or мою сестру зовут Юля. Now be careful with talking about dead. Dead is a man, so the word my in this case becomes моего. Моего. But the word for dead, папа, ends with а, so it becomes папу. Папу. Моего папу зовут Николай. Моего папу зовут Николай. Very well done. Now please do the drill number 3 as described in your transcript. Great. Very well done. So this is enough for today, and see you in the next lesson. Goodbye. До свидания.